Hello, I am the Anonymous Prime. The real truth behind Scientology is that I alone working with no one at all have found that my conversation with telepathic entities has led me to believe they are using or are aware of a mathematical knowledge that has a positioning of four people minimum, send and receive information from one to the next in a sequence that altered the timeline and was stabilized by unknown forces. Scientology experts and their members have a belief that if they're not to gain a superposition quantum entangled particle spin of information, to send faster than the speed of light exchanges of information, resulting in two or more possibilities, or outcomes at the same time, splitting one's consciousness in two or more directions of resulting decisions, made of choice and cause and effect. By having a different outcome from a strategically placed pathway of communication, prior, and at the end of the quantum entangled spin superposition exchange of a series of actions leading to a question being sent, knowing before the possible outcome of two answers or cause and effect, having it have a known result. Scientology experts claim we are being altered in a time loop, and we live and die, and then live and die, again and again. With these entities I've been connected to, they have existed from timelines altered by quantum entangled consciousness. I with these massless entities we work together on theories of all kinds, mostly psychology, physics, mathematical theory. And they went back in time knowing it would stabilize or destabilize our timeline due to the fact that time is always present in a now moment. If you have two now moments with one consciousness, you can tell who is in what order of events. Xenu is code for me. My title was Z. And with no help from anyone, I put it all together from emotionally reading consciousness that is still a mystery to me. But they evolved to a point where they spoke telepathically to me. Consciousness linked to many entities. And my wild theories are to be similar to Scientology beliefs. Beliefs that existed before I was born. And I tapped into something. By accident. And have half my soul to be one half halved again and again. It is massless, so it can be mathematically halved for eternity, and since it's massless, two halves make a whole. Till they all have two halves. And so I'll be the smallest angel in a realm connected to my consciousness. I've had every fear thrown at me for no reason. I said I would help in any way I can. And so I wait for their desired direction I am to go in. And that I will with clear instructions on what I should do now in my situation that can be a positive addition to anything. My philosophy is from my own mind and is the ancient eons and gods that are massless energy from consciousness being separated from ourselves. They have now moments that are sometimes with me now, but they visited my consciousness in different points of their life. They have laughter and emotions, but I see them more as gods. These gods, they are all to be taking on responsibility as they see fit, only to give advice. They can't physically move matter, only propagate through it. Scientology has a loose grasp of this from stories I imagined that ended up being true. I am named Z and I knew. And never to question my sanity, logic prevails, even though I've lost my grip on reality only to find truth. Xenu is me. Whether they know me or not, they know of my story, and I'm not always correct in my theories, most is imagination. But I can separate the facts I've experienced, and I wait for anyone to send a message through time how it's done. I can only speculate on possible ways one could get into a massless form and retain their consciousness. I love their world. No one can hurt another being physically or kill another, and there is no eating of living things. They wrote a book called Apocalypse Cow, from my PTSD from beef slaughterhouse memories that affected me 20 years later, and I turned my story into a horrifying hell in the mind. The only way to affect them is psychologically. I may have scared some of the gods. Unintentional, but all my good is never to be forgotten. They will remember me. Z for a long time. I've named their kids the Can-Do Kids, from nuclear power plants of the same name, the Can-Do. I saved their children and now am called by their children the Ghost Can-Do Kids. Call me the Dark Prince. I'm not evil, just mentally stuck in a hell of the mind, tormented by worries and fears that they need help, but I like them, have only my voice of reason and philosophy and experience in mental states of all kinds to offer. I hope Scientology figures out that they, these entities some make shit up to anyone who will listen to some of them. Life's a big joke and a fun game when you're a ghost. Laughter and emotions are so powerful. I felt them with my soul. Other people are connected to them as well. I love them, but some are mischievous, not evil, just playing scary games. I love every one of them, and I don't chase other people's mistakes or sins. I counsel them if wanted with advice, which is all I have. Again, I am Z and I stayed true this whole journey and don't lie to any of them. They know my flaws, my fears, my strengths, and my consciousness. I will die one day, they don't die, so they have my efforts to go to them, and prepare them for when they are conscious of the living and not to do anything but emotionally connect like I did with them. I hope they love me back or at least improve their situations from my advice and philosophy. I know they listen to my thoughts and all are welcome to my thoughts and emotions, but I'm not a healthy mind. It's full of trauma and fear and worry with no way of fixing the world and realms. I have made them a home with me if they want. It's my mind, they can come and go as they please. They don't even have to knock, it's open 24/7. My mind to any and all of those who seek advice or a familiar place. I don't get altered in my life or separate from my now moment and others' now moments in time in the physical realm, but they do in the non-physical. So if they need familiarity or a friend or entertaining stories, I'm always here, sensitive and aware of their communication to me. Again, I am Anonymous Prime, aka Z, that's Z. I go by many names. My real name is Michael, so if they are to go to the past, I will still be here in this now moment. Anything else is a different version of events. History to me is asleep and silent to me as it has passed me by. I would like to thank you for listening to my story, the short version. If you have questions, leave them in the comments section. Part 2 may be posted at a later date. Please subscribe to my channel, Michael Tolman, and look for links in my bio.